guys, welcome to 1A Drums. We've got Adrian here. This guy's a monster player. Tell us about this fill we're working on today.
Well, a lot of people ask me what's one of my favorite things to do, and for sure, it's the six-stroke roll. And, you know, in practicing the six-stroke roll, I've gotten really good at displacing it and putting it in different areas and putting it on the hi-hat, putting it on the cymbal. But one day I was practicing, and I accidentally displaced one of the hits with a kick.
And accidentally just made
perfect sense.
Beautiful sound. Wow.
So that's what happened.
I wish my accident sounded like that.
Well, yeah, that's how it came about. And I was just like, shoot, let me work on it. And
cool.
That's how it came about.
So when you're working on something like that, when an idea hits you or you make a mistake, do you then slow it down and try and really understand the placement?
Definitely. I would practice it at a slower pace for like at least 10 to 15 minutes straight. No breaking,
straight.
No nothing.
Cool. Yeah. So, and when you were practicing specifically a fill like this, would you play a groove, then practice going into the fill, then go back into the groove, like, to find the one? Is that what you're...
to find the one to make sure I can get out of it.
Get out of it.
There's times where you start a fill and you're just like, oh God, how am I going to finish it?
Yeah.
You know, so I make sure I practice.
That happens to you too? That happens to me all the time, man. That happens to you?
Yes.
I haven't heard that happen to you yet, but I have to just trust you on that.
Yeah, trust me. I've worked on it, but it used to happen a lot.
So that's how you break it down. Why don't you break this down for us really slow? Just start on the snare drum and explain the pattern itself, and then we can start to get into the subdivisions or displacing it. But
well,
start with that.
The six-stroke roll, I start it different. So I start with my left hand. Most drummers would start it with their right hand.
Why is that? Why do you start it with your left?
It gives it a different feel, and it allows me to, you know, have it. If I started with my right hand, that fill I would be crossing over with
course,
my left hand. So obviously, as I said before, keeping it open, started with my left hand and breaking it down.
And just as we start this, we're playing it as sextuplets, is that right?
Yes.
Okay, great.
Okay.
Why don't you take it away, demonstrate it on the snare, just the sticking really slow, and then we'll take it from there. That's it, man. So you're just going left, right, right, left, left, right, left.
Yep.
Right. And you, do you usually put that accent on just the first one?
Always.
You don't ever go da, 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 da.
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
Yeah, sometimes, but rarely. For this fill, yeah, I would just accent that one.
Cool. So it's triplet, triplet, right?
Yep.
Awesome. And then now we're going to replace that last right hand with a bass drum.
With
is that what you're doing?
Yep.
Do you want to demonstrate that really slow on the snare? Unreal.
Yep.
And then you're just going to move that around at lightning speed? Is that what you do?
Well, not lightning speed. There's some people who can do it way faster, but... just move it around, so.
I love the sensitivity there, as if you weren't just blazing this earlier. That sounds killer. So why don't you maybe show us really simple how you would begin to, if you're learning this for the first time, if you're a student like many of us are, just trying to get this idea down. What kind of groove would you play to go into it? How would you kind of develop the idea?
Well, it's, as you said, sextuplets. So I would put it in a 6-8 groove.
You love 6-8.
Yeah, that's my favorite type of groove.
Cool.
So I would put it in a 6-8 groove.
Awesome. Why don't you demonstrate that for us? And then that way we can start to see how it would fit in.
In a 6-8 groove, it'll be a different type of vibe.
Yeah, you've got me. I'm trying to figure it out in my head, too.
Exactly.
Killer.
To end off there, I normally do the double.
Right.
With the kick, yeah.
The last kick,
that's,
and then...
That's how you get out of it.
Yeah. So if you're going to demonstrate that same thing you just did, just a little bit more up-tempo, could you show us what that would sound like?
All right, cool.
I love that, man. I can't wait to practice it. And I love that you're leading it with your left so it opens up the rest of the drum set.
Yeah.
That's awesome. If you're going to fit it into a 4-4 vibe, how would you do that?
This one would be faster.
Yeah.
So,
very cool. So now you're playing it more as sixteenths.
Yeah.
One E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a one E and a two E and a three E and a four. Boom.
Yeah.
Cool, dude.
I had to have that space in there because I was like, okay.
Well, it's cool, man, because you're just thinking of this stuff kind of on the fly. I mean, I'm trying to help capture what you do.
Yeah.
Because you're such a killer player, man. And all this stuff, I mean, this is the other thing is you're never thinking when you're playing. It's just at this point instinctual. Like when you talked about earlier, you'll stumble on an idea.
Yeah.
Then you'll really work on it. And then you don't ever think about it again.
No.
It's just happening, right?
No, because everything that I've practiced and forgotten is engraved in me. And it will come out in your fills. The more you practice, obviously, the less you have to think about it. So.
How much time do you say, like when you're actually playing, how much of that time is actually you thinking about stuff? Do you try and really avoid ever having to think when you're playing?
I'm normally thinking about basketball.
Are you?
This
guy.
I'm rarely thinking about drums. Well, a lie. I'm practicing or thinking about like the groove. And I have to focus on the groove to make sure I don't like obviously add random parts to it.
Sure, yeah.
So I got to keep it as solid as possible. But when it comes to fills, no. I never think.
Cool. So it's just flowing out of you.
Yeah.
And this is something you use a lot, like you're saying.
Yeah.
And would you use it in that same way as well, like at 16th notes, just like that?
Yep, in 16th note, just like that.
Very cool. Yep. Dude, that sounds awesome. Well, thanks so much for breaking this down for us. Is there any other ways you'd move it around the kit? Is that the primary way you'd move it around? Would you move your left hand off the snare at all? Because right now you're kind of leaving it in the, on the snare.
See, I would start the six-stroke roll with my right hand and give it a different vibe. But it would still be the same.
Right.
So. I would start it, and it gives it a completely different feel.
Very cool.
You can move it around. I would move it around with the kick doing what the right hand is doing.
Cool.
So, yeah.
Awesome, man. See, when you say you'd move it around, say it again.
I'd move it around with the kick, so...
You want to demonstrate that a little bit more up-tempo?
In a groove?
All right. Dying to hear that, yeah. Dude, you're slaying. That's killer. Would you ever mix that idea with the first idea?
Yes.
Could you do it on the fly if I put you on the spot?
I would have to flip it around. Yeah, I think I could. I could figure it out.
Now I'm just putting you on the spot, man.
That's something along those lines. Like, you see how I stopped and broke it up and then did the other one? Like, that's stuff I didn't think about. Like, I would have to think hard and
right.
Like,
you have to sit there and work it out.
Yeah.
What's cool, man, I like doing that sometimes too, whether it's myself or to other teachers, because it's great to show students, like, we're just working on these ideas too.
Yeah, exactly.
And, like, you could take those ideas and sit down and explore with them as well. Exactly. But it's really endless.
Instead of, endless possibilities. Instead of accenting on the one, you could accent on the and.
Yeah.
I wouldn't attempt that, but.
Me either. I still got to just get this main idea down, man. I got to work on that.
Yeah.
Well, dude, thanks so much, man. We're going to head to the practice video now, and I'm really excited to actually just get to work on these at a really slow tempo with you. So
cool.
Thanks, man. Do you want to play us out?
Okay, sure.